Guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Today we're going to be visiting an old school technique called soaking or dead sticking. So you guys stay tuned from the honey hole for some fishing action. Hey guys, I brought out three baits today. We're going to be soaking or dead sticking Cinco. I brought a black and blue 5-inch Cinco by Big Bite Bait Company. This is a watermelon red Cinco. It's also by Big Bite Bait Company. And this is a tomato seed Cinco. This is built by a friend of mine that lives down in Mount Vernon. He gave these to me, Johnny Glasgow. This is, like I said, it's a tomato seed. I appreciate that. I hadn't seen this color Cinco in a long time. Wanted to give it a try out here at the honey hole. So y'all hang in there. We'll be right back with some fishing action. All right, guys, here's a little trick. If you're gonna be tying on something weightless and you're wanting to use something like a San Diego jam knot, you can hook you something just with a little bit of weight on it there. I just use my pliers or my fishing scales or something to keep resistance on that. Always remember to lubricate that knot, okay? Guys, I think we're gonna start out with one of these little tomato seed sluggos that Johnny gave me. And I'm just gonna hook this Texas rig, weightless. And we're gonna pitch it out there. And we're just gonna let this sucker sit. We'll let it sit in a spot for quite a time and then we'll move it just a little bit. We're just gonna let that bait soak just like it sounds. There we go. We're just gonna pitch this thing out there. I'm just watching my line. All right, there it goes right there. Just kind of letting them come along and find it and pick it up. I let it sink to the bottom. This technique works real good, especially on the first day after a front. When you got high bluebird skies and fishing's kind of tough, it works real good. Catches fish of pretty much all sizes, from big to small. It'll work on ponds, it'll work on lakes. I wouldn't say it'd work on a creek or a river unless it wasn't running, because the object is for you to just let that bait just sit there and you gotta watch your line. So we're gonna get right back out there and let it sink, see if we come up with another one. Give it about a minute or two, and if you don't see something, just give it a little twitch. I let it soak there for a few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes, and then if I don't pick up on something pretty quick, I'll move on to another spot. I like to get, you know, close to the covers I can. High bluebird days, they're gonna be sucked up tight to any kind of wood structure they can find, or if there's no wood, to the edge of a creek bank or something, they'll be up tight against it. This is a real slow, methodical way to fish. I think the most exciting thing till you get a big one on the line. This is really where you want to kind of know your fish habitats, what habits they like. This little flat right here, it's always been pretty good to me. Let's soak a bait out there. It's about 6 foot deep out there. You're gonna miss a few fish on this. I had one running with it. May have to do a little modification here. They seem to be wanting to carry it by the tail. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna move my hook up a little closer. Kind of put it in the middle. Now that's gonna give it a little bit of a different type of a fall. It's gonna be almost like a wacky rig. Or like a weedless. Weedless hover bait. Hover stroll. Now I know you guys seen that. That sucker about jerked my line. Hope y'all can see them ducks over there. He about jerked my rod out of my hand. You guys hang tight, I'm gonna have to go back and get another one. You guys see that, I moved it down and I also sprayed a little bit of spike garlic spray on there. See if we can make them hang on to it for a little bit longer. So y'all watch this. Letting it sink to the bottom. Watching the line. You'll see it. A lot of times they'll just pick that thing up, take off running. One thing you can do to kind of keep an eye on your line if it's running is turn your rod straight parallel to it, and you'll see it if it's moving to one side or the other. You can do this with a bait caster, you can do it with a spinning rod, either one, but like I said, you can do it with multiple baits. Weighted, weightless, weedless, shallow water, deep water. Just trying to pick my line up so I can watch it without actually moving my bait. We're gonna cast right down here around the edge of this cover and soak this bait right in that hole right there. I tell you what, it didn't soak long. Immediately got a bite. We'll have to re-hook here. I sprayed that scent right in the middle of this thing. Give him another shot at it. You guys see that? See my line? Well, son of a gun, he got off. I let him carry it a little bit that time, hoping I could make a better hookup with him. May have to go to a little bit smaller bait or something because they're grabbing this thing by the tail and toting it off. I may have to put a little bit of chartreuse on the around where the hook's at or something. All right, we're gonna go somewhere else, so y'all hang tight. All right, we come down the bank just a little piece. This next little water cover down here. Gotta be real patient doing this. All right, let's go try somewhere else. Let's go out to the deeper water. Go down here on this creek down here at the end. All right, guys, we've moved down the old pond a little bit here. There's a creek that runs down through here on the edge of it. We're gonna see if we can't fool one. I got a little bit of cover right here, right on this edge right here. There's a little bit of grass sticking up. I'm gonna try to, before I get too far out there, I'm gonna try to get right in that. I don't wanna drag one out of there and mess up one here. Thought we'd take a look there first. A little bait will skip pretty good like that. There's one nibbling on it. He's running with it. There we go. decent little old fish. He was mad, boy. He said, huh, I wanted that for dinner. He said, I think I'll try that. It's just laying there anyway. Little dead stick fish. Well, let's rig up and see if we can get us another one. He's right out on the front of that grass in about 2 foot of water. Let's slip out here in front of this grass. See what we can come up with. He just barely tapped that thing and then just picked it up and started swimming off to the side, and I nailed him. And they pick it up, you'll feel just a light tap and see your line kind of surge. I'm just letting it soak on the bottom. Watching my line settle. I'm using 8 pound fluorocarbon on this too. You know, fluorocarbon sinks. Well, I like it better on this type of bait, because it's gonna help that bait get down to the bottom and stay down there. I really believe that most of these fish, I believe if they see it fall and they run over and they stare at it for a minute, when it don't move, they pick it up. So I'm gonna hop it up, let it fall, and I'm gonna soak it a little while. You feel it when it hits the bottom of your line, just all the weight goes off your line. You can, like I said, you can do this with a craw or a lizard if you got any kind of current at all in your water. Light current, you don't want nothing that's gonna wash your bait down the river or the creek. We do this a lot down at Lake Welch, where that power plant water comes out. Use a little small weight just to get the bait down to the bottom quicker, and just let it kind of roll along the bottom. And they'll pick it up and chomp it. Hey guys, it's John. I want to thank you for joining us today. I went over the soak or dead stick method with you guys. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I know it's kind of short, but anyway, you get the gist of it. You put a bait on, whether that be a plastic worm or a jig. Throw it out there and let it sit for a long while. This is an old school technique used when the fishing gets tough. But so guys, next time you're out on the lake and the fishing's tough, throw you on a soft plastic or a jig, cast it out there and let it sit for 2 or 3, 4 or 5 minutes where you think the fish are, and see how your luck goes. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to thank you for joining the channel. Like I said, give us a subscribe, a like, and a comment. Old thumbs up. Y'all have a good day. Until next time, tight lines.